Shalom Aleichem. In continuation of our discussion of Tells and Lubavitch, last week I spoke about Tells in Europe, and I didn't finish some of the things that are still important. And that is that Reb Chaim Gutnik of Australia, the Lubavitcher Chosid, the Rav, the chaplain, he learned in Tells, I believe, from 1936 as a young bacher. I think he was 15 or 16 years old. His mother had contacted the Friedeke Rebbe and asked the Rebbe if she should send him to learn in Tells. For some reason, it was difficult to get to Otvotsk for her to send him to Otvotsk. She said she wanted to know from the Rebbe if it's a good yeshiva for him to learn in. She was an almana at the time. Her husband died several years before that. And the answer came back from the Friedeke Rebbe, it's a fine to send your son there because they learn Musa there. It's a Musa yeshiva. And that's a good thing. And send them there. That's one positive thing that we know of that Reb Chaim Gutnik always shared, that the Friedeke Rebbe said about the Tells yeshiva in Europe. And I think that this was a catalyst for the Rebbe's, for our Rebbe's feelings towards the Tells yeshiva later on in America, which seems to me from various stories, some of which I'll share either later or in another clip, were positive. The Tells yeshiva was considered one of the strong Musar yeshivas. Amongst the Litvish yeshivas, there were some that were pro-Musar learning during the Seder. Not that they learned three, like we in Chabad learn 3 hours Chassidus, but they studied, let's say, a half an hour every day. But in a serious way, in an organized way. And some Litvish yeshivas in Europe were very against it. This is a whole discussion that's been written about and studied and discussed. Excuse me. And we know who was for it and who was against it, some of which I've written about extensively in various books, Lakewood and Lubavitch, Rabbi Huttner and the Rebbe, etc. And in my next book, Chabad and Gedolim. So I shared the overall, we call the pulmus. The pulmus, it's a Hebrew word, not an English word. The pulmus of the Musar ideology, should it be as part of the curriculum or not? This was a very, very big difference of opinions amongst the Litvish Rosh Hashivas in Europe. It actually brought some yeshivas down, and other yeshivas it lifted up, meaning some yeshivas were so pressured not to do it that it caused turmoil and strikes and protests. Don't ask. Turning over of desks and tables, yes. The revolution of Bocherim against Hanhola administration didn't start here in America. It already was in Europe. And other yeshivas, literary yeshivas, were so for it. Slabodke, Tells, etc. Reb Chaim Gutnik had an older bacher who learned with him part of the time while he was in Tells. And who was that bacher? Rabbi Mordechai Gifter. Rabbi Gifter, how you do? The known Rosh Hashiva and leader of the Tells Yeshiva in Cleveland. I believe he came to Tells from America. He came to Tells from America in 1932. And he was older, 4 or 5 years older than Rabbi Gutnick. So he was an older bacher. And they developed a very strong kesher, a very strong connection, to the point that in the first time Rabbi Gutnick had yechidus with the Rebbe, I believe, was 1964. And he had a mission from Rabbi Gifter and the other Rosh Hashiva and Mashgichim of Tells Cleveland, who had questions on Lubavitch and the Rebbe and various things, to the Rebbe. And he kept up his kesher with them his entire life, and especially with Rabbi Gifter, so much so that in 1967 or 68, when he became a mechutin with Rabbi Yaakov Yehuda Hecht, Rabbi J.J. Hecht, his son, Rabbi Yaakov Yehuda's older son, Shalom Ber, married Rabbi Gutnick's daughter, and Rabbi Gifter came in from Cleveland to attend the Vort. And Shalom Ber said a mimer, and in the mimer he spoke about Oisis HaMachshava and Oisis HaDibur, Machshava Shebedibur, Dibur ShebMachshava, the letters of thought, the letters of speech, and one within the other, one incorporates the other. There's a whole discussion of this in Chabad Hasidus. And this was part of the mimer. After he finished the mimer, Rabbi Gifter, they asked him to say a few words, and he said, with what you said during the mimer, a ran in Masechtas Nedarim, which bothered me and I didn't understand all these years, I now have clarity in it. And he went on to explain what the issue, what his difficulty was, and how what he heard during the mimer clarified for him the dilemma that he had in that ran in Masechtas Nedarim. But I'm pointing out to you that there was a kesher haduk, a tight connection and relationship between Reb Chaim Gutnick and Rabbi Gifter. And this we'll talk about and more about Tells in Cleveland and Lubavitch in a future clip. Everyone should have a great Shabbos, a Freilichen Shabbos, a Lebedikin Shabbos, and a Chassidische Shabbos.